Hi, everybody. Welcome inside our brand spanking new CrossFit Update Studios. I'm Sean Woodland with Tommy Marquez, breaking down the teenage divisions for the age group online qualifier. And when you look at these kids, when you look at their scores, if you did not know that they were teenagers, you would look at their scores in their workouts and you would assume that these are athletes in the primes of their careers who are putting up these unbelievable scores, and then you realize they're teenagers and your ego takes a huge blow.
Yeah, I pretty much got no ego left at this point, Sean. I mean, I did three of these four workouts before looking at the leaderboard, getting depressed and seeing their scores compared to mine, and just giving up on the fourth because some of these scores are just fantastic. I mean, we're not talking about them just being good for their division. We're talking about some of the best across all divisions on this online qualifier.
Let's start with the 14 to 15-year-old division, and all the scores that we are going to show you are unofficial until Thursday at 5 p.m. Pacific time, but this is where we stand right now. Olivia Sulek finishes first by just 1 point over Leah Mallow. Sulek takes three of the four qualifier events in the process. Mallow finishes second by 18 points over Sonia Studnicka, and this Sulek versus Mallow matchup is clearly the one we're going to be paying attention to when we get to Madison in the CrossFit Games.
No doubt. Just 1 point separating both of these athletes. And then if you take a look at their results from the four workouts here, both have something to be happy about. Sulek wins three of the four workouts in her division. Certainly something you want to see carry on over to the games, hitting those home runs with the first place finishes. Mallow actually had a better overall point total if you take away the open finish there. So they're both neck and neck, just one point separating. And here's how close they were. In workout number one, only 5 seconds apart. Workout three, only 2 calories on the rower apart. In workout four, just 4 reps separate them. You're looking at maybe 18 seconds difference across 3 workouts. That's something you hope carries over to the games because there's very slim margins.
We only show the top 10 on that leaderboard, but there's a young lady in 18th by the name of Emma Spath. You got to see firsthand. What's impressed you about her?
Oh, man. I think this is just a good example for the entire community in terms of the teenage division. I know Emma because she goes to a gym local here in Santa Cruz at CrossFit West. It's the gym that I work out at when I'm not here at headquarters. And I've seen Emma really, really develop over the last year, going from 33rd in her age division as a 14-year-old in this division, and now as a 15-year-old making it to the CrossFit Games, seeing the level of dedication and perseverance, not just to become a good athlete, but bettering her fitness and everything kind of surrounding that with her parents supporting. And it's just been an awesome thing to watch. And hats off to her and hats off to all the other teens that fit in the same boat that have, you know, get to reward for all of their dedication.
We had a close battle on top of the leaderboard in the 14 to 15-year-old girls division. That is not the case with the boys. Tudor Magda runs away with this thing. He sweeps the competition. He won all 4 qualifier events, finished first in the open. Only person in any division to do that. David Garcia Vargas is the closest person to him, and he had a total of 38 points. So the question is now, as we head to Madison, who can stop Tudor Magda?
Right now, it doesn't look like anyone. You can't do better than perfect, Sean. And perfect is what Tudor's been across the competition so far, winning the Open, winning all 4 workouts here. If you take a look at all of the 10 scored workouts that he's had to perform, he's won 7 of the 10. A 70% win rate is just almost unheard of in this sport. The one thing you got to caution here, though, is he did much better in the Open in the online qualifier last year than he did at the Games. So you hope that maybe he got some experience in Madison, kind of learned from that. We won't see that regression in Madison once he gets there, because now he's the heavy favorite and the target's on his back.
One cool thing about this division too, and you can really see this across all the divisions, but really in the 14 to 15-year-old boys division, is that it has a very international feel. There are 4 countries represented in the top 5 on that leaderboard.
Oh yeah, and there's 8 international athletes out of the 20 that are going to the CrossFit Games. You look at some of the countries that are involved: Mexico, New Zealand, Canada, Venezuela, Iceland. And this is cool for 2 reasons, right, Sean? So one, because we see such massive international growth on a larger scale in CrossFit, whether it's affiliates or just general population during the Open this year. So it's nice to see that reflected on either end of the spectrum, masters and teens. The other is probably a more important thing, is just seeing how much the international youth are finding a passion in fitness and deciding to take their health into their own hands, whether it's competing or just getting involved in the gym overall. It's something that's very, very nice to see, in my opinion.
For sure. Let's move up to the 16 to 17-year-old division. We will start with the girls, and this is the battle that we expected to see. Haley Adams once again gets the best of Kayla Stefano in the qualifier, but remember, Stefano beat Adams at the Games last year. Between the two of them, they each won 2 of the qualifier workouts: Chloe Smith, Taylor Babb, and Devin Kim, rounding out the top 5. But this is the battle again that we talked about during the Open. We figured we'd see it during the online qualifier. Now it is going to go on to the games. What do you expect to see from this matchup in 2018?
I expect more of the same in regards to that. I mean, it's been probably one of the best kind of pairings, or I guess kind of dual threats that we've seen in the history of the CrossFit Games in any division. We're talking about between these two athletes, they have been in first place for the last seven stages of competition dating back to 2015. And for the last six, the other athlete who wasn't in first out of these two was also in second. Adams got the best of Stefano here in the online qualifier. Her event three score, or workout three score, was the best of any female master or teenager. But Stefano has the advantage of being the two-time champ coming into this year as well. She also competes in Olympic weightlifting, so she's usually kind of balancing two sports there, so we usually see the best version of her at the games. So really that just makes me excited to see just another chapter of what an epic rivalry.
The focus will clearly be on them when we get to Madison in the CrossFit Games, but Taylor Babb is a name that we mentioned. She's there in the top five, and you think she might be able to play spoiler here?
Yeah, there's a couple cool, unique things about Babb as an athlete. One, she's one of two athletes now to have qualified for the CrossFit Games in all 4 years of her eligibility as a teenager. The only other athlete is Vincent Ramirez on the men. Every single teenage competition at the Games, she's been a part of it. The other thing is, I don't think we've quite seen the best version of herself at the CrossFit Games. The last time she was in the older age bracket of a division was back in 2016, and she was a 15-year-old in that 14 to 15 division. Well, she won back-to-back events and then unfortunately had to withdraw. So she was on the verge of maybe making the podium there, had to withdraw from the CrossFit Games, didn't get to see that play out. Now she's in the older half this year, and hopefully the podium is in her sights.
Finally, let's go to the 16 to 17-year-old boys leaderboard. All scores unofficial until Thursday at 5 p.m. Pacific time. But this is the closest division for the teenagers. Dallin Pepper finishes first by 5 points over Dylan Cade, and 34 points separate first from sixth. So it's crowded up there at the top of the leaderboard, but when it comes to finding a favorite going to the CrossFit Games, you got to look at Dallin Pepper. And why do you think this kid could stand on top of the podium in Madison?
Well, there's something to be said about momentum, and he's on a little bit of a roll right now, Sean. He's won the last four stages of competition. That's the Games, Open, and Online Qualifier now, if you take into account the last 2 years and two age divisions that he's been in. And most importantly, his workout three score just leapt off the page to me. Of any athlete in the online qualifier, male, female, teenager, master, he had the best score. A couple days ago, me and Pat, before the competition started, were kind of curious if anyone was going to break the two-round barrier. Well, Dallin broke the two-round barrier and got 32 more wall balls, which means he had about a minute and change to spare after two rounds of that. That's just insane.
That is crazy. And we talked about how close this was. And another thing that sort of shows how much depth you have here is that nobody in the top five won an event. So this thing will most likely be close when we get to the CrossFit Games.
Absolutely. You look at the guys that are behind him, chasing him on the leaderboard. Four of the next five athletes have multiple years of experience at the Games. The one guy that doesn't, Logan Ewing, and he was 21st last year, so just barely on the outside looking in. Two of those athletes have been to the Games and made the podium as well. And then, like you said, none of the athletes had won an event. Every single athlete has a finish outside of the top 10, which means at the Games, there's the potential for that seesawing in terms of points, which really just kind of throws a grenade into the point standings there, which I love it. It's parity. Yeah. You know, you love to see it.
Yeah, the teenage division is going to be a blast to watch across the board when we get to Madison, Wisconsin, and the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games. We are going to continue to break down all of the age group online qualifiers. Tomorrow, we're going to have Roy McKernan here. We'll recap the 40 to 44-year-old divisions and the 45 to 54-year-old divisions. And then Friday, Tommy's back, and we'll take care of the 55 to the 60-plus athletes. That is going to do it for us for today. For Tommy Marquez, I'm Sean Woodland, and we'll see you right back here in our brand-new studio tomorrow.